Good afternoon, everybody, and welcome. It feels a bit strange to be performing here in an empty church to a camera, but I do hope that wherever you are watching this, that you enjoy it. This is a fundraising concert in aid of All Saints Church, so I hope by now there is a link in the chat for you to click on should you wish to donate. I've got a wide variety of music for you, including some songs which started out in stage shows and films, but have since become more famous as jazz standards. My first song is Putting on the Ritz, from the Irving Berlin musical film of the same name, followed by Johnny One Note, from Rodgers and Hart's musical Babes in Arms. Up and down Park Avenue, on that famous thoroughfare, with their noses in the air, high hats and arrow collars, white spats and lots of dollars, spending every dime for a wonderful time. If you're blue and you don't know where to go to, why don't you go where fashion sits? Sing one note, and the note he sang was this. Ah, oh, Johnny One Note sang out with gusto and just overlorded the place. Oh, Johnny One Note yelled willy-nilly until he was blue in the face. For holding one note was his ace. Couldn't hear the brass, couldn't hear the drum. He was in a class by himself by gum. Poor Johnny One Note got in Aida, indeed a great chance to be brave. He took his one note, yelled like the north wind, brought forth wind that made critics rave. While Verdi turned round in his grave, couldn't hear the flute or the big trombone. Everyone was mute, Johnny stood alone. Cats and dogs stopped yapping, lions in the zoo all were jealous of Johnny's big trill. Thunderclaps stopped clapping, traffic ceased its roar, and they tell us Niagara stood still. He stopped the train whistles, boat whistles, steam whistles, cop whistles, all whistles bowed to his skill. Sing, Johnny, one note, sing out with gusto and just overwhelm all the crowd. Oh,
is another tune from Babes in Arms and is a spoof of New York high society and its strict etiquette and phony social pretensions. It was also used in the film version of Pal Joey. This is Lady is a Tramp. I've wined and dined on Mulligan stew and never wished for turkey. As I hitched and hiked and drifted to from Maine to Albuquerque. Alas, I miss the Beaux-Arts ball, and what is twice as sad, I was never at a party where they honored nor coward. But social circles spin too fast for me. My whole Bohemia is the place to be. I get too hungry for dinner at 8. I like the theatre, but never come late. I never bother with people I hate. That's why the lady is a trap. From a film rather than a stage show. Get Happy from the film Summer Stock comes from the film Summer Stock, starring Judy Garland. This song was a favourite of hers and one that she performed in her concerts. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, come on, get happy. We're going to the promised land. We're heading across the river. Wash your sins away in the tide. It's all so peaceful the other side. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. You better chase all your cares away. Sing hallelujah, come on, get happy. Get ready for the judgment day. Forget your troubles, come on, get happy. Chase your cares away. Sing hallelujah, get happy. happy for the judgment day. Sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand. Shout hallelujah, get happy. We're gonna be going to the promised land. We're heading across the river, wash your sins away in the tide. It's quiet and peaceful on the other side. Forget your troubles, get song Judy Garland performed in her concerts and comes from the musical 42nd Street. This is Lullaby of Broadway. Come on along and listen to the lullaby of Broadway. The hip hooray and ballyhoo. The lullaby
Sleep tight, baby.
And now, a cautionary tale from Kurt Weill and Ira Gershwin's musical Lady in the Dark. This is The Saga of Jenny. There once was a girl named Jenny, whose virtues were varied and many, excepting that she was inclined always to make up her mind. And Jenny points a moral with which you cannot quarrel, as you will find. Jenny made her mind up when she was three. She herself was going to trim the Christmas tree. Christmas Eve she lit the candles, tossed the tapers away, and poor Jenny was an orphan on Christmas Day. Poor Jenny, bright as a penny, her equal would be hard to find. She lost a dad, a mother, a sister and a brother, but she would make up her mind. Jenny made her mind up when she was 12 that into foreign languages she would delve. But at 17 to Vasker it was quite a blow that in 27 languages she couldn't say no. Poor Jenny, bright as a penny, her equal would be hard to find. To Jenny I'm beholden, her heart was big and golden, but she would make up her mind. Jenny made her mind up at 22. To get herself a husband was the thing to do. She got herself all dolled up in her satins and furs, and she got herself a husband, but he wasn't hers. Poor Jenny, bright as a penny, her equal would be hard to find. Deserved a bed of roses, but history discloses that she would make up her mind. Jenny made her mind up at 39. She would take a trip to the Argentine. She was only on vacation, but the Latins agree. Jenny was the one who started the good neighbor policy. Poor Jenny, bright as a penny, her equal would be hard to find. Oh, passion doesn't vanish in Portuguese or Spanish, but she would make up her mind. Jenny made her mind up at 51. She would write her memoirs before she was done. The very day her book was published, history relates, there were wives who shot their husbands in some 33 states. Poor Jenny, bright as a penny, her equal would be hard to find. She could give cards and spades to many other ladies, but she would make up her mind. Jenny made her mind up at 75. She would live to be the oldest woman alive. But gin and rum and destiny play funny tricks, and poor Jenny kicked the bucket at 76. Jenny points a moral with which you cannot quarrel, makes a lot of common sense. Jenny and her saga prove that you are gaga if you don't keep sitting on the fence. Jenny and her story point the way to glory for man and womankind. Anyone with vision comes to this decision. Don't make up, you shouldn't make up, you mustn't make up, or never make up. Anyone with vision comes to this decision. Don't make up. Comes from Leonard Bernstein's musical Wonderful Town, with lyrics by Betty Comden and Adolph Green. Ruth Sherwood is amazed at her sister's ability to attract men and her own talent for repelling them. Girls,
Are you constantly bothered by the clawing attentions of the male sex? Well then, here's the solution for you. Get Ruth Sherwood's new bestseller, 100 Easy Ways to Lose a Man. Chapter 1. Now the first way to lose a man. You've met a charming fella and you're out for a spin. The motor fails and he just wears a helpless grin. Don't bat your eyes and say, oh, what a romantic spot we're in. Just leap out, crawl under the car, say it's the gasket and fix it in 2 seconds flat with a bobby pin. That's a good way to lose a man. He takes you to a baseball game, you sit knee to knee. He says the next man up at bat will bunt, you'll see. Don't say, oh, whoops, a bunt, this game's too hard for little me. Just say, bunt, are you nuts? With no outs, 2 men on base and a left-handed batter coming up, we'll walk right into a triple play, just like it happened in the 5th game of the World Series 1923. That's a sure way to lose a man. A sure, 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 sure way to lose a man. A splendid way to lose a man. Just throw your knowledge in his face. He'll never try for second base. 98 ways to go. The third way to lose a man. The lifeguard at the beach that all the girlies adore swims bravely out to save you through the ocean's roar. Don't say, oh thanks, I would have drowned in just 1 second more. Just push his head underwater, your last one in's a rotten egg, and race him back to shore. That's a swell way to lose a man. You've found a perfect mate, and it's been love from the start. He whispers, you're the one to who I give my heart. Don't say, I love you too, my dear. Let's never, never part. Just say, I'm afraid you've made a grammatical error. It's not to who I give my heart, it's to whom I give my heart. You see, with the use of the preposition to, who becomes the indirect object, making the use of the word whom imperative, which I can easily show you by drawing a simple chart. That's a fine way to lose a man. A fine, 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 fine way to lose a man. A dandy way to lose a man. Just be more well-informed than he. You'll never hear or promise me. Just show him where his grammar is, then mark your towels has and has. Yes, girls, you can lose a man if you will use Ruth Sherwood's plan. 100 easy ways to lose a man. And now a parody of a famous jazz song. The Boy From is a parody of The Boy from Ipanema. Many thanks to Christine Smith for her assistance with the last word. Like an Apollo, he goes walking by, and I have to follow him. The boy from Tacarembo, La Tumba del Fuego, Fanta Malita, Zacatecas, La Junta del Sol y Cruz. When we meet, I feel I'm on fire, and I'm breathless every time I inquire, how are things in del fuego, Fanta Malita, Zacatecas, La Junta del Sol y Cruz. Why, when we meet, does he vanish? Oh, why is he acting so clannish? Oh, I wish I friend. Tall and slender, moves like like a dancer, but I never seem to get any answer from the boy from Tacarembó. La tumba del fuego fantasma lenta Zacatecas la junta del Zoli Cruz. I've got the blues. Why are his trousers vermilion? His trousers are vermilion. Why does he claim he's Castilian? He says he's Castilian. Why do his friends call him Lillian? And I hear at the end of the week he's leaving to start a boutique. Though I smile, I'm only pretending, 'cause I know today's the last I'll be spending with the boy from Tacarembó. La tumba del fuego fantasma lenta Zacatecas la junta del Zoli Cruz. Tomorrow he sails, he's moving to Wales to live in Clanfai Puchgwin Gilgo Gerach yn drobwl Llanti Silio Go Go Goch. And now, let me take you back to 1971 and the soon-to-be-demolished Weissman Theatre. There's a reunion of the performers from the Follies shows going on, and one of them sings her show-stopping number, Broadway Baby. I'm just a Broadway baby, walking off my tired feet, pounding 42nd Street to be in a show. Oh, Broadway baby, learning how to sing and dance, waiting for that one big chance to be in a show. Oh, gee, I'd like to be on some marquee. The dark from Battery Park to Washington Heights. Someday, maybe all my dreams will be repaid. Heck, I'd even play the maid to be in a show. I'm on a bill all over Times Square. Someday, maybe, if I stick it long enough, I will get to strut my stuff. Working for a nice man like a Ziegfeld or a Weissman in a big time Broadway show. Something more contemporary now. It's 2001, just after the September 11 attacks have taken place, and 38 planes have been ordered to land unexpectedly in the small town of Gander
in the province of Newfoundland and Labrador in Canada. Me and the Sky, from the musical Come From Away, tells the story of Beverly, the pilot. My parents must have thought they had a crazy kid, 'cause I was one of those kids who always knew what I wanted. They took me down to the airport to see all the planes departing. Watching them fly, something inside of me was starting. I was 8 when I told them that I'd be a pilot, but I was too young and too short, and there were no female captains. And my dad said, be patient, he said, just see what happens. But I took my first lesson, came down from the sky, and told my father I'd fly for the rest of my life. Then I got my first job, flying for a mortician in a tiny bonanza, just a corpse and me. $5 an hour for flying dead bodies. I had to climb over their faces just to get to my seat. But suddenly the wheels lift off, the ground is falling backward. I am suddenly alive. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly everything's changed. Suddenly I'm not too young or too short, and the passengers in the back don't complain. Suddenly I'm flying company charters. Suddenly everything's high. Suddenly there's nothing in. American Airlines had the prettiest planes, so I applied as a flight engineer. But the World War II pilots, they all complained. They said girls shouldn't be in the cockpit. Hey lady, hey baby, hey, why don't you grab us a drink? And the flight attendants weren't my friends back then, and they said, are you better than us, do you think? But I kept getting hired, and the World War II crew, they retired, and the girls all thought much higher of me. 1986, the first female American captain in history. Suddenly I'm in the cockpit. Suddenly I've got my wings. Suddenly all of those pilots protesting me, they can get their own drinks. Suddenly there's no one saying stay grounded, looking down, passing them by. Suddenly there's nothing in between me and the sky. Suddenly I've got an all-female crew. The news stopped, it made headlines across the world. Suddenly it stopped, no one's saying you can't, or you won't, or you know you're not anything, 'cause you're a girl. Suddenly I'm getting married, and we're putting pins in the map where we've flown. Suddenly I am a mother, and suddenly shocked at how much they've grown. Suddenly I'm wondering how my parents would feel seeing me teaching men to be pilots, 'cause suddenly I am a senior instructor, and somehow I'm 51. Suddenly I'm flying Paris to Dallas, across the Atlantic and feeling calm. When suddenly someone on Edgware traffic says at 8:46 there's been a terrorist action, and the one thing I love more than anything was used as the bomb. Suddenly I'm in a hotel. Suddenly something has died. Suddenly there's something in between me and the sky. And now, a song from Wicked. I haven't got time to go and green up, so you'll have to imagine that I've got green skin. Elphaba, who later becomes the Wicked Witch of the West, dreams of meeting the wizard. Did that really just happen? Have I actually understood? This weird quirk I've tried to suppress or hide is a talent that could help me meet the wizard. If I make good, so I'll make good. Once I meet the wizard, once I've proved my worth, and then I meet the wizard, what I've waited for since birth. And with all his wizard wisdom, by my looks he won't be blinded. Do you think the wizard is dumb? Or like Munchkin so small-minded? No! He'll say to me, I see who you truly are, a girl of the wizard, my whole life will change. 'Cause when you're with the wizard, no one thinks you're strange. No father is not proud of you, no sister acts ashamed, and all of us has to love you. And by the wizard you're acclaimed. And this gift or this curse I have inside, maybe at last I'll know why. As we work hand in hand, the wizard and I, one day he'll say to me, Elphaba, a girl who is so superior, shouldn't a girl who's so good inside have a matching exterior? And though folks here to an absurd degree seem fixated on your verdigris, would it be all right by you if I degreenify you? No, of course, that's not important to me. All right, why not? I'll reply. Oh, what a pair we'll be, the wizard and I. Yes, what a pair we'll be, wizard and unlimited. My future is unlimited. And I've just had a vision almost like a prophecy. I know it sounds truly crazy, and true, the vision's hazy, but I swear someday there'll be a celebration throughout Oz. That's all to do with me. And I'll stand there with the wizard, feeling things I've never felt. And though I could never show it, I'd be so happy I could melt. And so it will be for the rest of my life, and I'll want nothing more.
I'd just like to remind you that this is a fundraising performance, and there's a link somewhere in the chat for you to click on should you wish to donate. I'd also like to say a very big thank you to Mike Griffiths over in the AV corner for all his technical assistance, and also thank you very much for watching. I do hope you've enjoyed it. This next song, I'm sure you all know it. This is Somewhere Over the Rainbow.
Thank you.
whole world is a hopeless jumble, and the raindrops tumble all around. Heaven opens a magic lane. When all the clouds darken up the skyway, there's a rainbow highway to be found.
Beyond.